Very exciting new feature from SmartSuite. We are now able to pre-fill forms, and we can pre-fill fields on a form and then hide them from users so that they don't even know that information is being passed into the form. If you're ready to learn more about this feature, including going in step by step to build a URL for our form that pre-fills information, you're in the right place. So stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools, and SmartSuite, the very software that we're covering here in this video, is one of our favorite tools to use for database purposes, as well as the front-end dashboards and automation potential. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, we're going to be diving into this new feature for pre-filled forms, and we're going to be going step-by-step to build our own URL. We're going to write each little part, and I'm going to highlight for you all the different components and what they're used for. But before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. If you're new to no-code tools, automation is the most powerful thing about this kind of software. It allows you to automate those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do day in and day out. You will be stunned at how many hours of your day can be automated, allowing you to focus on higher value tasks. So grab my free automation training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here. We're going to be jumping into a solution that I'm going to outline before we get into the form building component. Now, I invite you to follow along with me. If you already have SmartSuite, open it up and follow along. And if you don't, please consider signing up using our affiliate link. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. I'll include that link wherever you found this video. So let's go ahead and hop on in here. We have tasks and users, two simple tables in our task solution. So tasks are pretty high level here. We have a priority, we have a status, so we can kind of track how this task is going through its various stages. We, of course, have the task name. This is where we would write out what the task is. We have a due date for these tasks. You can see I've just set them all to be 14 days in the future. And most importantly, we're linking to users. And the reason for this is because over here we have a users table. And so we can list out our different users. And here you can see I've got four different examples. I've included myself and actually assigned this to me. So we can actually use this assigned to field here to bring in somebody. And this is a great way to access different users in SmartSuite. So I'm assigning it to the SmartSuite user. But for our purposes in this demo, we're going to be linking to the actual name, to the person, that is, the user record here on the users table. Now, you will also notice that I have the user record ID right here. We're simply using a formula here. This is a formula field, and we're calling up the record ID. If you're kind of new to no-code tools like this, you might not know, but this is an important concept. The record ID is assigned to every new record as it comes into existence. And we can, of course, refer to records by their name. This is the title right here. But it's very likely that, especially in a large organization, we could see duplication here. There might be two Sally Johnsons, for example. Well, if we use the record ID, this thing right here, this will always be unique. This is a unique identifier for the record. So I strongly encourage you, if you are going to be, as we are in this example, pre-filling information for a linked record, then I strongly encourage you to use the record ID, although the record ID or the title here will work. Okay, so let's start to break down the syntax that we need for our form, and I will include a link to this support article here. The key takeaway is right here. These are the different components that we will need to use when we prefill our link. The first part is the actual form URL. This section right here, the form URL, this is generated by SmartSuite. So when we create a form in SmartSuite and we publish it, it will give us the form URL for the form we just created. Then we have to enter in this question mark. The question mark is an important step because it's telling the URL, hey, there's more going on here. We're going to actually pass you some information and we need you to do something with it. Now, after that, we have to write prefill, and please note that case sensitivity matters here. So prefill is all one word and it must start with a capital P. Then we use the underscore And then the parameter here is the thing that we want to prefill, the field that we want to prefill. And note that SmartSuite says in their documentation that we can use either the field ID or the field name. So just as I was mentioning that we can use the record ID or the title of the record, we can also use the name of a field or the ID of the field. To keep things a little simple in our example, we're going to be using the title of the field because I also want to highlight for you what to do if you have characters in the field title that might not be conducive with a URL. And if that didn't make a ton of sense, I think you'll understand as we go into our example. So again, we need to do the question mark and then write the word prefill underscore. Then we're going to fill out whatever that field name is, immediately followed by an equal sign, and then we have to plug in the value. And when we do all of these pieces correctly, that will then send that information for us. And when we load that URL, it's going to be prefilled with information in our form. So let's break this down step by step, and we're going to flip back now to SmartSuite and look at our tasks. And you'll notice that I've already created for us a form. So let's take a look at it. It has the task name as a required field. We're linking to the users. We have a priority set, and we have a status. Now, all of these pieces are optional except for the task name, although I could also make the link to users required because, of course, if we're going to create a task, it must be linked to a user. But for our example, we'll just keep it as it is. Now, in order to publish your form, you must click in the upper left corner and say form share view. So right here where it says form is shared, make sure to toggle this on. If this is not toggled on, the form is not published and it won't be readily available. Now, thinking back to the syntax that we found on the support article, the first component is the form URL, which is right here for us. So we're going to copy this, and now I'm going to open up in a notepad here, and we're going to just kind of go through step by step as we work through the syntax. So I'm pasting in this URL. This is step one, form URL. Next, we have to use that question mark. Now, in order to make this easier to see the different components, I'm going to be using carriage returns or new lines, but understand that when you actually use this URL, it's going to all be one long string. There will not be carriage returns in the URL. So first is the form ID. Next is a question mark every time. After that, capital P, R-E-F-I-L-L, prefill, underscore. Now we have to bring in the value. What are we going to be prefilling? Well, let's flip into our form really quickly. Take a look. We're prefilling link to users. That's what we want to prefill. We want to prefill it with a specific user when we load this URL. So link to users, easy enough. Link to users. Now, here's where things get tricky. We cannot include certain characters in a URL because you've never seen a URL that has a space in it. They don't exist. There are many different special characters that are not conducive with URLs, and a space is one of them. Now, if you want to hard code this, that is, like, instead of typing the space, you can actually come in, go to that support article that SmartSuite provided, and if we scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see the encoded output here. So a space does not exist or cannot be computed in a URL. We must use the encoded output of %20 or %20. This is when you see it in a URL, basically saying, hey, this is a space. So we can use this, this legend, this key right here, and the legend output. You can use these manually when you write out your URL. Now, there's another more advanced way of doing this as well. If we're writing a formula or a function, I'm going to show you that towards the end of this video. But for now, we're going to grab that %20, and we're going to go back into our notepad here. And everywhere that we had a space, I'm going to replace it with %20. I'm just copying and pasting, nothing too fancy. So what do we have here? Let's break it down again. Form ID, the form URL, question mark, prefill. Then we're putting in the value that we want to prefill. What's after that? It's an equal sign every time. And then lastly, what we want to prefill is whatever value we want to plug in there. So for us, let's take myself as an example. I'll flip back into our users here. Let's say I wanted to prefill myself in this URL so that when we load this form, it's prefilled with me as the person who's going to be assigned this task. I can use my name, but as we already saw, some characters don't get translated very easily. So the fact that I have a space here, I don't love it. Also, we talked about redundant entries if there's two Sally Johnsons in the future. Which one's gonna get pre-filled? Your guess is as good as mine. It's better if we use those record IDs. So because we're pre-filling a linked record, we can use a record ID. I'm just gonna copy this record ID, flip back into my notepad now, and paste it in. All right, so these are all the components. We're saying we're going to pre-fill the link to users field with this record. Let's copy this whole thing, and I'm gonna pop open a new window here, a new tab, and just paste that in, and go to this URL. Now it's gonna load up my SmartSuite form, but notice that the link to users is already filled out. Let's test it out. I'm gonna say task five. I'm not gonna select priority or a status for now, I'm gonna submit. What's gonna happen? We're gonna flip back into SmartSuite, look at the tasks, and we're gonna go back to our grid view here, and you'll see that task five is now created, and it's been automatically assigned to me. Super simple. Easily linked, and we didn't have to fill it out on the form. You'll also notice that priority and status were filled out to be normal and backlog, and this is because I've set up default values for each of these fields. So if they don't get filled out in the form because they're optional fields, they're still gonna take that default value when the form is submitted. Let's take this a step further though. Let's go back into our form. Let's imagine that for privacy reasons, you don't want people to see a link of users. Like, really quickly, let's go back to that form. I'm going to reload that URL that I still have copied. Right now, if I say, I actually don't want it to be Gareth, I can click on it, and I'm going to see a list of all the other users. Maybe this is a privacy issue. You want to keep this private. You don't want people to be able to see a list of all of the different records in your database. Well, let's hide the field then. We're going to pre-fill the field and then hide it so that people can't actually access it like this. Super easy to do. We simply come back into our form and we click the link here, the particular field that we want to hide. And right here we have the option to just say, hide this from users, the end. And now just like that, we don't even have to resave this. If I reload this URL, I'm just hitting refresh on my browser, it's pre-filled with me as the user, but you can't even see it. There's no way for you to even change that information. A sophisticated user might go into the URL and delete the record ID, but the field is still hidden from view in the form. So when I submit this and go back into SmartSuite and I look at my grid view again, now I have task number 6. It's still been assigned to me even though you didn't see it in the form. Let's talk now about what happens if you want to pre-fill multiple components. Well, SmartSuite has said it's simply the same thing again, although you only use the question mark in your syntax the first time. So if we want to pre-fill something else, we're simply going to come down and write an ampersand. So the second, third, fourth, fifth, etc., any additional variables past the first one will always then have an ampersand. Again, you need to then say prefill underscore, and let's suppose we want to prefill the status equals, and then we'll say backlog as an example. So now, if I were to use this, we're going to be prefilling two of the components on the form. Let's go back and open up a new tab here. I'm pasting in what I just created. And so here you see that the status is prefilled to backlog. You cannot see that I've prefilled the user, but it is pre-filled. And let's create task 7 now. And when we submit this, it will create another task here, task 7. And of course, backlog is the default value. So if we don't put something in, it's gonna go to this status. But in this case, we actually passed that value through on the form. So we could have passed through any of these values, in process, ready for review, or complete. All right, the last part we're gonna cover here is how to write this in a formula, because it's great that we're passing in a user record ID, but what if we want it to be variable? We want it to change every time. Well, let's go into our users and actually create a button to do this very thing. I'm gonna create a button field, and I will say, rename the label here to assign task. And we're going to choose the action of opening a URL, but we're going to use a formula to do this. I'm going to pop open the formula and we're going to write it step by step here so that when we push the button, it opens up the form for that particular user. So we're going to go back now into our notepad. Let's pop that back open. And I'm going to disregard the second half of this that we wrote. We're only going to be working with this top component here. So we're going to be prefilling the user. So let's write a formula. We're going to do a concat formula. And this formula is basically saying we're going to string together a number of different elements. Now, the first of those elements, I'm going to indent here, it's going to be the URL. So let's go back into our notepad here, and I'm going to grab the part that is static. Number one is the URL here, but then I'm also going to include the question mark. It's static. It's the same every time, as is the prefill underscore here. So all of this is the same every time. Let's grab this, and I'm going to go into my quotations and paste all of this. I don't want the carriage returns here, so I'm deleting them. So now we see that we've got the form URL, question mark, prefill underscore. That is the first component of our formula. Comma. Now we're going to go down to the next line. What happens now? We have to put in the field that we want to prefill. And for us, if you recall, that field is called link to users. So I'll say link to users. Now, here's where if you don't know about %20s and spaces and you have a broken URL, this is how a formula can help you, because we have the ability to bring in a formula called encode URL. Let's drop in here. Encode URL component is this function that will allow us to look at a piece of text or a formula of sorts, and we can automatically translate it to a URL. So inside of these quotes, I have a link to users, and with those spaces, they're automatically going to be translated to something a URL can actually read. So it's going to automatically put in those %20s in our finished product here. So let's look at it again. We've got the form, we've got the question mark, prefill underscore, we have the link to users, which is the name of the field that we're prefilling, but we're surrounding it with the function of encode URL component, which automatically puts in the different characters and translates the parts of this that are incompatible with the URL. Now, after we've identified the field, we're going to end that with a comma to tell the formula that we're going to put in another value now. And again, all of these are going to get strung together in that concat function at the end of the day. Now we need to do an equal sign. And because the equal sign is a string, we need to do it inside of quotations. So bear in mind that after the field that we want to prefill, we have to say equals as if to tell the formula, hey, this is the actual value that we want you to prefill. Okay, now after that, again, we need another comma. Let's drop that in here. And now it's time to bring in that record ID. So for us, we have the record ID function. We can also just call the record ID of that user because we're in the users table. I'll just use the function that we already built here. And that's it. We don't need a comma for our last element in the function. Let's go ahead and save this up. We'll say apply down in the bottom corner, and we will update this field. And now when we hit this button, we're going to be prefilling the form for whatever user we selected the button for. So let's go down here to Jane Pamchenko. We're going to assign a task for her. Now, bear in mind that while we're prefilling this form with Jane, we've also hidden the value. So there's no privacy issues, no concerns of that nature. We'll say task 8 here. We'll go into priority. We'll say, let's say it's urgent, and we can assign this to in process. We'll submit this, and you'll see when we flip back now into SmartSuite that we have the new task, urgent, in process, but most importantly, it's been filled out for Jane. It's been assigned to her thanks to our prefill forms in SmartSuite. Now, I realize we covered a lot in this video, and it's a little bit technical in that we have to go line by line when we are writing this out, but at the end of the day, it's such a great output. Now we have buttons that we can share in dashboards, we can share them in emails. Because of the fact that we built this button using a formula, it's very dynamic, and we can use it in all kinds of places. Now, I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Swing by our website with any questions, but most importantly, keep on building.